Greetings and welcome everybody to Swing at Sway. We are back here with another exciting instalment of Swing at Sway Online.
And tonight we invite you for a quintessential British cream tea.
Absolutely, chaps, I say what? Spiffing, absolutely spiffing. So we are going to have a cream tea. So I want to know, have you got your cream teas ready? We have ours. We have some lovely scones and tea. Which is actually brewing.
We'll have to bring them to the camera.
We'll have to bring them to the camera. No, we'll do that in a minute.
All in good time.
So who have we got here? Have we any one of our YouTube tea group? We've got Glenn, rather, and Sue, one lump or two. Exactly, that's what I always say. And anyone else? I'd like to know, has anyone... Oh, Alevitina, hello.
Alevitina, hello.
Lovely to see you. Hope everything's good. You've come to join us for tea. That's wonderful. I hope you've got your English Grey, Earl Grey or something. But we've actually got rooibos today, haven't we?
Oh, Simon, you're giving it all away. Oh,
I'm giving it all away. Okay, was I not meant to? Right, well, we've got our tea coming up. But as always, we like to start with a bit of dancing, don't we?
We do.
So this is your chance to get up off your seats and come and join us on the dance floor. We are going to do a little warm-up. And we did it last week, but it was a nice little stroll, so we're going to do it one more time. Right, come and join us, folks. Boys and girls, ladies and gents, it's time for some...
Dancing.
Dancing. Are we ready? You're adjusting the screen. Okay. Right, We're going to start. If you weren't here last week, you can pick it up and follow. If you were here, then come up and join us. We go left, close, left, right, close, right. We go forward and back and two to the left. Let's repeat that one more time. We step left, close, left, good. Right, close, right. We go forward and back, stop. Just do the forward and back. Forward and back, stop. One lump or two. No, and then we'll go two more to the left. Left, close, left, tap. From
the tibbity top.
The T. Five, six, here we go. Two to the left, two to the right, forward and back, and two to the left. Tap, kick, down, tap. So the end, we ended up with a kick, down, tap. You kick your right foot to the corner, take it across and tap the toe. Make sure the toe comes off the floor, and then back to the corner and down. Kick the left foot to the corner. Take it across and tap the toe and back to the corner and left, right. So let's do the second half. We go 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Was it perfect? Yes, I hear them cry. Okay, this time let's make it a little bit more bouncy. So as we go, tap, kick, tap, down, kick, cross, and a twist. So we're going to make it bouncy, and we're going to add some twists on. One more time. We go, tap, kick, a down, corner, cross, a down, corner, cross, freeze, swivel and step down. We do it four times from the tee. 5, 6, here we go. Two to the left, two to the right. Oh, I'm building up a nice thirst here. And two to the left. And kick. A down, kick, cross. A down, kick, cross. And a 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, if you had a partner, you could, of course, do it together as a twosome, a T for two. We go left, close, left. Right, close, right. We went forward and back. Two to the left, tap. Kick, a down, kick, cross, a down, kick, cross, and a swivel, 2, 3, 4. Let's do that much once. Are you ready? Music. And music coming up. Soon as the orchestra get themselves set up, and my baby just cares for me. 5, 6, 5, 6, here we go. Spice it up a little bit, give it a little bit of spice. Now, who have we got watching us? We've got Glenn, we've got Sue, we've got Katrine, all with a tea and cake. Lovely. Bjorn, hi from Sweden, but B.
Oh,
what was that? I can't see.
Sorry. But
we'll only be
partly
present today. Bjorn, only partly present. Well, we are. Don't miss the tea, whatever happens.
Valentina says, hey, and we have Nicola and Esther online with us.
Yes, where's Valentina living these days? I think she travels around so much. She's probably in some exotic country.
Oh, probably.
But is she going to have a quintessential British cream tea? That's what we need to find out later. So, one more time from the top. We go left, right, close, right. We go forward and back, two to the left. Tap, kick, down, kick, cross. Down, kick, cross, freeze. Four steps. If you're with a partner, the person on the left, traditionally the leader, would be going to their right. If you're on the left, you go to the right.
And the person on their right goes to their left.
Well, that makes sense. And we go 1, 2, 3, 4.
There you are.
We're now facing a partner. And then we do our same basic steps. left, close, left, right, close, right. We go forward and back, two to the left. Tap, kick, kick, a down, kick, cross, a down, kick, cross, freeze. Now we're going to turn the same direction. So I was on the left, so I went to the right.
I was on the right, I go to the left.
And we go step, 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 step. We end up back where we started. Now, if you had a partner, we do the same thing. A left, close, left. A right, close, right. We go forward and back. Two to the left. Tap, kick, kick, in, down, kick, cross, down, kick, cross, freeze. What if we've got a partner? We want to guide leaders. You're going to guide your partner away with four steps. One, two, three, four. So we're diagonally opposite. Exciting. And then we go. Left, close, left. You notice how we sneakily swapped hands. Very sneaky. A right, close, right. We went forward. Admire our partner. Hello, how are you?
Oh.
And back. Very, very polite. And left, close, left. Tap, kick, kick, a down, kick, cross, a down, kick, cross. And I'm going to use my right hand because I'm going to pull my partner across as I take this four steps. One, two, three, four. And then we start from?
From the top.
From the tip. So I think, Anna.
Yes.
We should start it without a partner.
Uh-huh.
And then we'll do it with a partner. Now, if you want to be the leader, you want to be on the left, and you're going to copy me.
And if you want to be a follower, join me on the right.
Join me. My side's much better. My side's much better. Okay, here we go. Five. Oh, yes, I forgot the music, yes. Oh, yes, I was so carried away with my humour. Get that group going, yeah. One, two, we know what to do. We go left, close, left, right, close, right, four, back. A down, kick, cross, a down, turn. A one, two, three, four, left. Not there you are. A right, four, and back. Two, turn, the left. Show you some of the classes that are on our membership SwingdanceUK website. Yowza, that's the moment you've been waiting for. I know you're all excited about this. We had a beginner's class. It was number 7. And it started with what is known in the trade as a tuck double turn. And it looks like this. A push, a tuck, a double turn. How about that? What a great move. And then we added a circle. A 1, 2, circle, and around we go. Then we went into the mooch. Now this is a bit of a smooch on this one. A mooch, a through, a middle, a mooch. And then we didn't just do a normal mooch. We did a kick and a slide. Let's show you that again. Push, tuck, double turn. We did circle. We did a mooch. A long, a low, a through, the middle. Kick, up and slide. Yeah, cool move, huh?
Very
cool. So, if you want to learn that, where do they learn it, Anna?
On the membership site on swingdanceuk.com.
Yeah, not bad. Check it out.
How about the intermediate?
We had an intermediate class. Now, the intermediate class was a bit of a tricky one this week.
Or was it?
And I don't think you've done it for a little while, so I'm going to have to see if I can remember it. We're going to start. Well, let's start with the circle. So, start with the circle.
I can do that.
Then I decided to do a rock step, then I changed my mind. A rock step, stomp, and a peck, peck, peck. So that was a little cheeky move there, a little pecking, great for tea. We had a 8-count reverse. A 1, 2, 3, a 5, 6, 7, with a free spin. 2, 3, a 5, 6, 7, 8. So we did 2 8-counts in reverse. Then we added a send out. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We put hold. And there we went, and out, and in, and out, and out, and out, and in, and out, and in, and in, and in. There's a little, we call that a ba-dum. We went ba-dum, 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 with sound effects. Then we did a tuck turn, into our sailor step. We strolled around a few steps. And we get a little slide to the side.
I got out of the screen.
Oh, you went out of the screen. Oh, dear. Right. So, should we put that all together? So, we started with a circle. Let's start with a circle this way. We went circle. 5, 6, 7. We're a rock step stomp. Broken record. A rock step stomp. We did a circle. We did a circle with a spin. 5, 6, 7. We did send out. Double hand. And push, tuck, turn and around, step, step, slide away. And that was the intermediate class in week 7 of series 2. Week 7 of series 2. And where do they find the class?
SwingdanceUK.com.
So if you want to learn some cool moves, we've got them all on our website.
Members area.
£15 a month, which is an absolute bargain for about 100 live classes.
100?
Yeah, they're not over there, 100. They're live. Over 100, yes. There's lots. And we've got a special surprise coming up. Let's tell the people about our special surprise.
Okay, this is going to be very exciting. Is it a surprise?
Well, it's not a surprise. Well, it won't be a surprise after I tell them. It's a surprise right now, of course.
Oh, they're going to love that one.
Our special treat coming up is we have a guest who will be doing some workshops on our membership site, the lovely Mariangela from Athens Lindy Hop. So she'll be doing a couple of workshops, so you can check out some Lindy Hop there about improvising. So very excited. So that'll be coming out soon.
Lovely dancer, lovely teacher, a very feminine style, and just a great person to know about.
Yeah, so that's Athens Lindy Hop. Now, let's see who else we've got here. So Glenn says, M slaving over a hot scone, and Jennifer says, hi from Midway. Oh, you're in Mid Wales, Jennifer. Wow. Yeah. Is it cold there? Have you got snow? Here it's all melted. We've got Gregory from Frankfurt. We've got Derek.
Good
Don't forget, night. When in Devon, you put the cream on your scone first and then the jam on top. Mm-hmm. Well, that's not the only way they do it in Devon.
Well, in Devon it is.
Well, we're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about that. So from sunny Devon, and of course Devon does have a big history with the cream tea, as we're going to find out. And Emma says, the scones are ready and I love that stroll. Thank you. Fantastic, Emma.
Do you think that the scones are ready or the scones are ready for Emma?
Ah, now that's a very good question. Now,
I think possibly Glenn said scones last time.
Okay. If you think it's a scone, I want you to give us a like, a love, or just let us know. If you think it's scone, say now if you think it's a scone. And whilst you're doing that, Anna's going to see who's on Facebook.
Right. On Facebook, we have Martine from France. Hello, bonsoir, Martine. Great to have on the show. We have Ilona online and John. We have Raj. Hi, Raj. Great to see you. Frank and Mike as well. Oh, Camille in France as well. We've got France all
Fantastic.
Over. Dancing in my kitchen with you, my friends. Well, that is lovely. We're so pleased to have you, Camille, and maybe the whole family or part of the family. Rick says, hope you tuned into my Saturday swing nights. I actually don't know about your Saturday swing nights, but we found our Monday swing nights. We'll look it up. Thank you, Rick.
Charlie, welcome. Nice to see you.
Charlie and, oh, I left it now. It's in Montenegro.
Montenegro. Ah, fantastic. Well, that's exciting. So who's up for scones as opposed to scones? So who says Sue, scones? This is for scones.
Swan,
this is the vote.
So Sue, Glenn, Jennifer, a scone as in gone.
A scone as in gone, quite right. As opposed to a scone, which is a tone. A tone for a scone?
I thought you meant a cone.
A cone for a scone. Oh, I like cones even better, more tasty. So, if you're voting for a scone, write the word gone. If you're voting for a scone, write the word cone. So, let's repeat that. So, it's because it's a bit confusing, isn't it? If you're voting for a scone, then you write the word cone.
And if you think it's scone, write the word gone.
And then let's have a, we can count up the votes. Are you going to be the official adjudicator?
Am I? Well, I think we should count one each.
Okay. I think, you know what I would say? If I knew you were coming, I'd have baked you a cake. So come on, guys, let's get dancing. Let's do a bit of dancing. Here we go.
Just make some space for those scones.
Come in. Well, look who's here. I haven't seen you in many years.
Warmed up. Now, bearing in mind we've been eating a lot of cakes today, we have to think of our Fitbit and our number of steps.
Yes.
So if you've got a Fitbit or something similar and you're marking your steps, we haven't done that for a while. So I made a note of how many steps I started with. And we'll see how many steps we finish with tonight. Normally I go between 3,500 and 5,500. So it varies. Now, have we had any votes for the strongs and the gongs?
We've had some votes. We have gone, going gone, cone for a scone, but I'm from Sweden. Well, it still counts. Gregory is saying cone, so all our international audience is voting for cone, and all the UK base seems to be voting for scone.
Actually, I say scones. I'm a scone. I'm a cone man.
I used to say scone, and then you corrected me into scone.
Yes. So I don't know. Well, I don't know if anyone knows as well. Hello, John. How are you? Nice to see you. Watching from America. Which part of America are you in? I can't remember which part is he from. DC? I can't remember. And we've got, who else have we got?
We have Deirdre.
Rick has voted for gone. So
Rick
is scone.
So gone. On Facebook, you're a bit shy on the votes. Let's hear it. Is it scone? Gone for scone or cone for scone?
Yeah. Now, I think there is one important thing we mustn't forget.
What's that?
They
cream?
Both taste good. Okay, so we have some freshly baked...
Is it time?
Scones, no.
Scones or scones?
We have some freshly baked scones or scones that baked by my own personal baker, Miss Anna. And but I must say that I decorated it with the strawberries on the side.
That's just my portion.
Yes, that's just
your
portion. Well, let's say this. I've got the cream, and what could be better than Rhoda's cream? Oh, this is marketing, advertising. Rhoda's cream.
Is there any other cream?
We have got some special jam. Now, it's not English jam. This is bon... How do you pronounce it?
Bon maman.
Bon maman. And it's very nice strawberry jam. So that's what we've got coming up later. Oh. And of course... we've got to have a cup of tea because we're British.
Absolutely.
Now, I must tell you,
yes,
as a British person, I am a bit of an expert at making tea because it is actually, for anyone that doesn't know, anyone that's not British, tea drinking is something that we are just born to do. We grew up...
I think they should see the tea...
Oh, don't spill it right. There's a cup of tea for you. Oh, I'm not doing
very
well here because I'm focused too much on pouring the tea rather into the cup than out of it. But, okay, so...
Why, thank you.
You think they should see? Now, we've got a very special teapot.
We do.
Have you noticed? Yes.
Quintessentially British as well.
Oh, yes. Very well. Unfortunately, I forgot my cup.
Oh, dear. No, it's... Oh, yeah. I'll hold on to this.
This show is slick and polished, as you can imagine. Now... So I want to know if anyone else pour into the cup. Well, you know my grandpa, he was famous because he used to
I would hold your hand to your towel, but you took mine already.
Yes, I know. I would I'd tell you about my grandpa. He used to put his cup he would put his tea in the saucer if it was too hot and slurp from the saucer. But I've been told that's not the done thing these days. Now, would you like a spoon to stir the sugar?
I do love those spoons, but there is no sugar in
them. We don't actually take sugar anymore, because sugar's old hat. That's old fashioned. Does anyone else take sugar, or is it now a thing of the past? One lump or two. Yes, but what I do have to teach everybody is about the finger. It's very important. Now, I've often wondered why people put the finger in there, and I did wonder if it was to tilt. You know, use it like a lever to tilt the tea. Let's have a slurp. Mmm. Delicious. Absolutely divine.
Now, normally, this would be Earl Grey tea or maybe Darjeeling tea, the Rolls Royce of teas. But tonight, we're going rooibos. Because Simon, Englishman Simon, is not a fan of tea.
No,
Would you believe it?
Would you believe it? I don't
actually
drink property. I don't drink property. You know, builder's tea. We're going to come back to the builders later. But what I want to know is, what is your favourite brew? So all you tea drinkers out there, what is your cup of choice?
What's your cup of tea?
What's your cup of tea? Tea-wise. Let's hear from people. June, what's your cup of tea? That's what I want to
know. I would say, what colour should your tea be? But that might be more difficult than gone and cone.
Now, Glenn says bone china, of course, nothing else, Glenn.
Absolutely.
We only have bone china and crystal. Ding!
What are they called in French? They're not called in France. That we don't have cream teas in France. I regret to say, my mom and I for years tried to identify what was the actual recipe for scones, but we couldn't really reproduce it in France. I don't know if there's differences in the flour or in the butter or in the water, but they never tasted the same.
Probably the quantity of sugar.
We adapted the recipe, and we had sort of brioche buns with whipped cream and jam, but I've been told that's not quintessentially British.
Now, Rick is a Yorkshire tea man.
Oh, Yorkshire tea.
And Sue, on the other hand, is chamomile. She doesn't drink black tea either. So a chamomile person. And Katrina, strong cup of builders.
With plenty of milk.
Oh, yes, that's a good cup of classic.
So again, it sounds like the internationals here are more into tea than the British.
Yes. Now, what does Beyonce say? I've heard that the biggest something of the British tank after the First World War was a tea boiler. Was that a tea boiler was installed? The biggest
improvement of the British tank after First World War was that the tea boiler. Oh, inside the tanks. Oh, that's wonderful.
But hold on a minute. When they're driving along, how if they're making tea in a tank and it's going over all that bumpy ground, they're spilling it everywhere.
One hand on the wheel and one hand to hold.
I don't believe. Beyond, I think you're kidding me. Cheryl, what's your favourite tipple in the tea market? What do you like to drink tea? We've got a rooibos here. I bet Cheryl's a PG tips person. Let me guess. Now, let's see what Albertina say.
Albertina says black tea with milk, my favourite. So builder's tea as well.
Albertina, how can it be black if you put milk in it? It won't be black anymore.
Well, it's not green tea.
And June, I hate tea and only drink coffee. Shame on you.
Are there any
June,
Brits?
I can't believe it. Unbelievable.
Any tea drinking Brits around here? Jeff is saving us. Yorkshire gold leaf. Loose leaf always. Well, loose leaf is nicer.
Yeah, so we've got two votes for Yorkshire. So Yorkshire is bidding.
Jennifer has chamomile tea or coffee. We're all the tea drinkers in England.
Well, I'm not one of the coffee drinkers either because I don't drink tea or coffee. I'm a very unusual Brit. There we go.
Glenn is more on the Irish side or maybe the Scottish side. Breakfast tea, strong dark with a drop of whiskey.
That sounds like you want to have one of those every day. Now,
not sure you want it for breakfast, though.
I think we should do some more dancing. What do you reckon? Enough tea?
I think enough tea drinking? Well,
okay.
Never enough tea, but let's dance anyway.
Well, you know, I don't know if this song is really about tea, but it's about when I take my sugar. So I think...
Nice transition, Simon.
Nice transition. But we're going to do a Charleston jam. Now, if you don't know what a Charleston jam is, it basically copy Anna. Copy one of us. We'll be doing different things. We'll be doing some solo Charleston and everyone can join us. Katrina is another Yorkshire original. Bags or berries, of course. Okay, so Yorkshire is doing quite well, isn't it? Breakfast tea for me, loose leaf when I have the time. Well, yeah. All these tea drinkers. What's your favourite cup of tea? What do people in Lithuania drink in the way of tea? I bet it's strong and I bet it jumps.
Jumps?
Yeah, it makes them jump over fires. Come on, let's dance a little bit. So everybody up. Charleston Jam, you don't need a partner for this one. You don't even need a cup of tea. But what you need is to be on the dance floor.
Or the kitchen floor, or the living room.
And Charleston. Okay, windmill. That's enough of that. So what about going for a stroll?
Oh, yes.
Let's pick more back.
hothead bee. She's a hothead, baby, that she. And I never take her where the gang goes. When I take my sugar duty. Every Sunday afternoon, we forget about our care. Open the food restaurant with a vision.
Round in a circle.
When I take my sugar 50, I'm as busy as I can be. Cause I never take her where the gang goes. When I take my sugar 50.
Swing on. One more time. Have we got joining us? So we have Katrine, who else on YouTube? No, nobody else on YouTube. So who's on Facebook?
So Yeva says, we drink green tea, mint tea, or anything that's growing on the tree.
Oh, you're so healthy, Yeva. What can I say? So healthy. Rick said, lovely tune.
Yes.
Lovely tune.
Which was?
When I take my sugar for tea, the Savoy Orpheans, bit of Charleston-y foxtrot. And Mendup, hello Mendup, nice to see you again. So glad you could join us for a cup of tea. So, Mendup, I hope you've got your tea. We're all having a nice cup of tea here. It's the quintessential cream tea. And very soon, we're going to be breaking out the cucumber sandwiches and the cream tea. Mm. Now.
Now, am I mistaken?
As always.
Am I mistaken to think that cucumber sandwiches do not belong in cream tea?
You are quite right. Mm. So we have a question for you. If cucumber sandwiches and little pastry cakes do not belong in a cream tea, what does belong in a cream tea?
And where do cucumber sandwiches belong to?
Yes, that's a very good question. And I think we're going to have a super prize for the person who can tell us.
Mm-hmm.
The question was?
The question is, why don't cucumber sandwiches belong in... Why do they not belong in cream tea? And what do they belong to?
What do they belong to?
Where do they
to?
Belong?
Exactly. Now, June says, that scared my cat away. Was that my jokes, June? Was that my jokes? Or it was my dancing that scared your cat away? I don't know what she's talking about, really. I don't.
Katrine is saying, high tea. Now, I think that's close.
That's very close.
I think you could have sent it for high tea, but high tea...
I don't know.
High tea is a little bit different.
I'm going to have to look that up.
That's not the answer we were going for, Katrine, but very close.
June, I'm going to bring your cat back. So June's cat will be rushing back.
Yeah, I don't know about
she's
the cat,
the cream.
But I'm here.
Yes. Now, so what is the difference? Actually, I'm going to look it up right now. What is a high tea? I don't even know what a high tea is. So let me just do a quick bit of research. Anna, tell us a joke while we're waiting.
Well, no, but I was just realising that we're having a tea dance, aren't we?
Yes, we're having a tea dance.
We are having
do you know
a
that's
dance.
What I first... I used to do that at the 100 Club. We used to have tea dances.
That's right.
But yes.
It's hard to imagine a tea dance at the 100 Club because for me, it's a place that smells of beer.
Ah, yes,
that's
true.
Really associated with tea.
No, we didn't have much tea either, actually. It wasn't really tea.
More a dance.
No. So a high tea is a substantial late afternoon or early evening meal at which tea is served. So there we go.
Yes.
So
no,
so, yes,
earlier.
You were right.
Earlier.
Well, it's more of an early evening meal.
Yes.
And I don't think you necessarily have scones or scones.
Scones.
No.
Now you're saying scones.
Yeah, well, now I'm all confused.
Sides.
Now I'm all confused. Okay.
We'll come to the real controversy very shortly.
Anna, tell us about your week. What's been happening?
Oh, my week. What's happening this week?
That's what I asked
I'm
you.
I'm trying to remember. It feels
did anything
like,
happen this week?
Actually, we did step back into the garden because we can finally feel spring is coming. I know, not to get too excited, but it is milder and the days are much longer. and I spent a bit of time in the garden trying to sort my broccoli from whatever has grown over them during the winter.
Yes, we don't spend enough time in the garden, I must be honest. You know, gardening and cream teas, we just don't give them their fair dues, do we? Now,
oh, no.
June says it was my Charleston that scared the cat away. I don't believe it, June. I don't believe it. Rick says you must come to the Riviera Swing and have some sandwiches.
Swing.
At the we did go, didn't we?
Well, I don't think it was Riviera Swing,
oh, no,
but we went.
One.
We did go to Devon, and it was Torquay.
Torquay.
And we did have cream tea.
What
and
was the event
dance.
Called? Palm Swings.
Palm Swings, which is lovely. Well, I don't know about Riviera Swing, but that sounds any place that has tea, cream, and dancing.
Sounds good.
Sounds great.
Rick,
to me.
We'll await our invitation in the post. Right. So.
Yes.
And what does Derek say there?
The high tea is a meal eaten in the late afternoon or early evening, typically consisting of a cooked dish, bread and butter and tea. Yes. So high tea is more of a dinner time meal. And is it true that a tea... Well, in Northern England, dinner is called tea, which is very confusing.
Yes.
Because you have bread for tea and then... No, you have...
Ulvis. Nice bit of Ulvis.
Ooh, Ulvis.
Oh, yes, Ulvis up north. Now, Derek, you're a very educated man. I'm very impressed with that answer. Derek knows his stuff.
Oh, Sue has an explanation for poor foreigner me.
Oh, yes.
So high tea is what my mother used to give me before I was old enough to stay up for supper.
Ah, but I bet you were from up north, Sue. Were you from up north? I bet you're... No, not a Sassenach. I bet you're from up north. Right.
The pronunciation of scones is apparently important. Oh, it is beyond. And we haven't yet started on where to put the cream and where to put the jam. You want to stay tuned for this one.
Oh, yes, we're going to come back to that. Right, so you were telling us about your week. So, yes, we've been out in the garden. We went for a nice walk in the local forest.
Yes.
And we went to a different part of the forest we hadn't been
to
before.
Oh, we did, yes.
And,
well, we had been, but otherwise.
I couldn't lose you. You still came back with me. I tried to lose her, but, you know, I couldn't get rid of her.
I had my little pieces of scone.
You did.
No, that wouldn't work with me. I'd eat it all.
No, anyway, I think it's time for a bit of Bob Crosby right now.
Okay.
Time for Bob Crosby. So, anyone, tea for two. There's a bit of a theme going on here, isn't there?
Tea
for two, not two for tea. Well, we could be two.
Me for you?
Me for you and you for me, and tea for two with Bob Crosby.
That makes three of us.
Come and join us on the dance floor.
Thank you.
wonderful Bob Crosby Orchestra. Did you know Bing Crosby's brother? Now,
Bing and Bob, did the parents have something with bees?
Oh, yeah. Bees. Busy bees. It's in November. 3 days of dancing, bands. You would absolutely love it.
That's Riviera Swing.
Let's hope it's on this year. Rick, yes, we'll keep our fingers crossed. Oh, yes, indeed.
That sounds absolutely lovely.
Right, Riviera Swing, fantastic.
And we have Julia Anna, who's joined us for tea. Welcome, welcome. Pour yourself a cuppa and join us on the dance floor. Or on the chat floor.
So there's some questions. What are the questions?
There's a lot there. Questions, or should we start... Where do we start?
Start from the top, work down.
Yes, that's where I'm going. We hope to see you again in Tokyo. Oh, well, Derek, we do hope to go back to Tokyo. It was such a lovely event, wasn't it?
It was
really nice.
Well, in fact, we had a cream tea there, didn't we?
Well, that's why we mentioned it.
Yes, okay. Tell me why.
Were you there 5 minutes ago?
Yeah, no. I was too busy having tea. So,
how do you pronounce this word? Because I've read it, but I've never heard it pronounced.
A Geordie.
My mum was a Geordie, so that's someone from the north.
Ibaekithum, that's from the north. I'm not. Is that Newcastle, Geordie? I think it's a Newcastle. Afternoon tea, preferably with a glass of bubbly. Ooh, very nice too.
Bjorn has done his research.
Oh, right. What's he found
about
out?
Scone and scone. So a YouGov survey, not any old survey, a YouGov survey has revealed that most people agree the correct way to say scone is when it rhymes with gone rather than bone. Research reveals that most Britain, 51%, pronounce it to rhyme with gone.
Well, it's like Brexit, 51% is a majority.
It's like Brexit, with around 4 in 10, 42%, rhyming it with bone. It's marginal, but there's still a winner here. So what about the remaining 7% of Brits? Do they not talk about scones and scones?
Oh, they're uncivilised.
Uncivilised.
So it rhymes with gone, so it's scone.
Oh, Glenn has a point. Who cares about YouGov when what matters is how the Queen says it?
Ah.
So, but how does the Queen say it? Can we find out? Should we give her a call?
Right.
Give her a ring.
Rick says, I must have you two come into my swing dance in Brighton to do a workshop. It would be lovely.
Thank you, Rick. Very nice. That would be lovely.
Just let's get COVID over first.
Yes.
Yeah. But hopefully we'll be back.
To come out, we'd love to come.
Now, Rick, if we come over, I'm going to give you Anna's recipe. And I think, Anna, do you want to create... Do you want to show? Now, the question is...
Uh-oh.
Now, this is the big question.
Is this the one?
I'm not sure. I'm a bit confused. Do we put the jam on first... Or do we put the cream on first? Now, there seems to be a difference of opinion. So I'd like to know how many people put the cream on first and how many put the jam on first. Now, we have the jam.
Shall we have a vote to know how we should eat our scone?
Scone is gone. It's no bone.
Okay,
it's gone
today because we've voted. There's a majority. I think we have even more than 51% today.
Look at that clotted cream. Oh.
Well, I'll have this with a spoon.
Yes.
I'll do me. So okay. Cream first or jam first?
Okay, well, I think we'd better let people decide
before we do it.
Now,
we need to wait.
Also, at 8:30, it's our birthday jam. So does anybody have a special event they're celebrating? Because we'd like to celebrate it with you. So if it's your birthday, your anniversary, you've won the jackpot, whatever it is, do let us know and we can celebrate with you. In Sweden, we had dances on Sundays between 3 and 5. That was called The Dance. Don't know when it died out or when it started. Emma says, Butterburst. Emma. Oh, you're in trouble. We don't have butter with scones or scones. Oh, Emma, I can't believe you.
Emma's solution.
No.
Butter, whatever.
There's no butter and a cream tea. I think everyone would agree with me.
There is no butter and a cream tea.
I can't believe, Emma, you said that.
But the cream is almost like butter, I have to say.
Emma, I can't believe. And Glenn says cream first.
Into the scone.
Actually, I like butter with mine as well, if I'm honest. But that's another matter. Cream first, the Devon way.
Catherine says...
Okay.
Yeah, first. Sue has a reason. cream first. You can spread jam on cream, but you can't spread cream on jam.
Oh, well, now, okay. I don't know if the Cornish would agree with
that. I would agree with that, but the other half of the world seem to disagree.
Okay, so listen, guys.
And Jennifer, who's further west in Wales, says jam, then cream.
Ah,
ooh, controversial.
Jam, yes. Well, so the question is it jam or is it cream? Because we don't know how to make ours because we've never made one before.
We can't eat it.
So
well,
so what are we going to do? Now, I've heard about a Devon one that I like, and this is my favourite. You put the cream on first, both halves, and then you put the jam in the middle.
And you make it into a sandwich.
And you make it into a sandwich. Now, that to me is the ultimate. But
it's almost like putting butter.
But in Cornwall, they like to put the jam on first, don't they? So in Devon, they put the cream on first. In jam... they put, Rick says it's cream first.
Rick votes for cream first.
But then I think he's a Devon man. and then from Cornwall, they like to put the... now, from my understanding...
Yeah, so who was first?
Who was
first?
To
make cream tea.
Who was the... Who? Yes, well, that's the quiz question.
Oh, is that the
because
quiz question?
We never got the last one answered. So the quiz question, and you've got a wonderful prize awaiting you. the quiz question is, who had the first cream tea? Okay, have we got time for one more song before we...
I don't know about another song, but another cup of tea would be lovely.
Another cup of tea. Mm. Well, I'll tell you what, baby. Hold tight, because I've decided I want some seafood. Should we dance?
Let's dance. Decided, are we having jam first or cream first?
What's the decision from the adjudicators?
Let's see if there's more votes. Cream first. Tea dancing to be. Oh, yes. Oh. Be honest, I thought that's what you said.
Glenn had a fishy afternoon with his tea. He had salmon sandwiches. Woohoo! You're living it up a bit.
Very nice.
Oh, Derek. You see, I told you Derek's an educated man. He knows his stuff. It originated in the Tavistock Abbey during the 11th century. Derek, you have won a prize. Now, which strawberry would you like, Derek? We've got some strawberries for you.
Any.
Would you like the large red one or the slightly smaller pinky one? Because Anna's going to get to eat it. Or should I eat it? I don't know. So maybe...
I think you can have it first.
Yeah, well, I think Derek should decide.
Oh, right.
Who gets the strawberry? Is it me or Anna?
So his prize is to give us a strawberry.
Yes, but he can only choose one.
What a wonderful prize. What a wonderful prize.
What a wonderful prize.
Now,
absolutely
wait
wonderful.
A minute, Simon. 11th century in England, in Tavistock. I don't think they had tea then.
Well, let me explain to you what happened, Anna. It's very simple. About 50 or so years before, there was those Vikings were coming, Bjorn. Some of your relatives were coming over and causing havoc. And they absolutely were destroying the local monastery, the local abbey. And the abbot wasn't very happy about that. So some local milord decided to get all the local villagers, the workers, to come and renovate and reconstruct the abbey and make it look all beautiful. And the monks were so happy. They decided to make a treat for all the builders. So they made bread with jack cream and jam. And they created the first cream tea. It wasn't called a cream tea.
It was a cream.
So it was a sort of a jam and cream sandwich for the workers. So really what you can ascertain from that is that cream teas are really like builders' PG tips. It's builders' cream tea because it was for all the workers who were renovating the abbey in the 11th century. I thought that's wonderful.
Now, I'm not sure that's not a bit cheating, Simon, to call it a cream tea before tea had arrived in England. So when was the first cream tea with tea?
Ah, well, that's a very, very interesting question, Anna, and I'm glad you raised that one. I'm going to play some music and then I'm going to come back with the answer.
Derek says they probably drank scrumpy. I don't know what scrumpy is.
Scrumpy cider. Oh, yeah.
Oh,
the nice bit of scrumpy.
Oh, right.
Oh, yes.
So cream cider.
Not cream cider.
No, well, they didn't have cream tea.
Cream
they
soda.
Had a cream cider.
They had a cream cider. No, scrumpies are not creamy at all.
But in cream tea, you don't put the cream in the tea. Cream tea, you eat the cream with tea. Oh, well, Simon, let us play some music.
Okay. So... the question was, when did tea come to the UK?
Oh.
That is a good question, that. And I'm going to guess around the 1650s.
Oh, you are you?
Yeah, I'm going to guess around the 1650s. And I think it was probably Chinese tea was first.
Uh-huh.
And it's probably those Dutch that brought it over. Now, I'm not just a pretty face, you see. I can
googly face.
I can come up with the answers too, Derek. Derek said they probably drank too much scrumpy. No, they drank scrumpy. Yes, you're quite right. Now, it's time for a birthday jam. So if anyone's celebrating...
Oh, birthday jam. So you got the jam?
We got the jam.
Where is your birthday?
Yes. Now,
who's having a birthday
we're gonna go
or
for
a
something
special
a little bit
occasion
tonight.
To celebrate?
We're going to go for something slower. It's a song I have played before, but I do rather like it, actually. It's a friend of mine called Nile Oates has a band called Ronnie Scott's Rejects. And this is one of their songs, and it's Tea and Sympathy. So this is for anyone celebrating a birthday. Now, what happens at a birthday jam? What happens at a birthday jam is that you get to dance with everyone in the room. You know, you don't eat birthday jam yet. You get to dance with everyone in the room. So if you haven't got a partner, just make a few up, because that's what we're going to do. See if you can spot when we switch partners. Sometimes it'll be Anna switching partners, and sometimes it'll be me switching partners. What that means is we end up with different people. Glenn, oh, hold on. Emma says, jam first. She can't type while eating her butter-coated scones.
Fair enough.
Oh, and Derek says Anna has won the prize.
And he says the biggest one, please.
Derek, oh, the biggest one, that's over there.
Thank you, Derek.
Don't get
that's
it all
very
down
kind
your nice dress.
Oh, that's very kind. Do you want to share, Simon?
No. Derek gave you the prize. I'm hopefully going to win the next one.
Delicious.
So,
thank you.
Derek, you've made a friend. You've made a friend. Hopefully I will win the next one. Andrew's birthday jam first and then birthday cream. Nice one, Andrew. Okay, tea and sympathy. And then, of course, We're going to do the Shim Sham Shimmy. Oh, we're going to do that after tea.
Oh, well.
So tea and sympathy, and then Shim Sham time. So grab your partners. It's a nice slow one, this.
Thank you. about 3:30. My daddy said, son, come here to me. Says things they come and things they go. But this is one thing you ought to know. It's the way how you do it. It's the way how you do it. It's the way how you do it.
That's what gets me.
Mama. It's the time that you do.
The red card, but I don't know if it's because of the music or because we said jam first.
Oh, yes, that could be right. Right, Anna, it's up to you. I want you to make two scones, one with jam first and one with cream first.
Right.
And then we're going to taste them both, and we are going to give you. You don't need that. We are going to give you the official opinion of the Swing at Sway, official opinion of which is. Right, is it jam first or cream first? So we're going to do one of each.
It's the jam.
The jam? I'm keeping that hostage. The Bon Maman strawberry conserve, very nice.
Do you have a separate spoon?
No, actually that was meant to be... Oh, you can use the knife for the jam.
Yeah, there's another spoon for... Oh, yeah.
I do have another question. If we know the first cream tea, would you like me to help you? If we know the first cream tea...
I don't want to put it on my dress.
Ooh.
Thank you very much. That one did it.
If we know the first cream tea was in the 11th century, when was the modern cream tea popular? Now, we actually have a date because I've done my research and we have a date. Does anyone know when the first cream tea was really popular? Lindy, Lizzie, Abrahams, I bet you know when the first cream tea was popular.
Lizzie is a bit of a specialist tea, right?
So we're putting cream on first on one and jam on first on the other. And we are going to be your official... tasters, and we are going to tell you which we think is the best, and that is the definite opinion. That's the official opinion of Swing at Sway, and that is what everyone is going to have to go by. That's what I say. But we could start a civil war, couldn't we? Oh. There could be a civil war over this.
So, almost there, ladies and gents. Now, I have to say, it was very easy to put the cream first. I'm now attempting to put the cream on top of the jam.
Not too bad. You know the war's over. you know the war finished. Rationing's over. So you could have, you know, it could be a bit bolder. Right, okay.
Is that bold enough for you, Simon?
Oh, that's very bold. Very bold indeed. So we also like to talk about, this is the moment when we're talking in the show about our tip of the week.
Is that for me?
Yes. So what, it goes with your strawberry. So what is the tip of the week? This week is...
I think we can put that aside for the moment.
Wear proper dance shoes. Tip of the week, to improve your dancing.
Last week's tip was
get a proper teacher.
Yes, this week's tip was wear proper shoes. It was recent.
No, I think not.
You think not.
Well, maybe
still,
somebody
it's
has
just
watched.
As true as it was last time.
Yes, that's true. Maybe somebody has watched all 50 shows, and they can tell us.
But I was there.
Did we do that? You were there. Well, that's what you say. Now, okay.
Right. Simon, so, I need a top up.
You need a top up.
A tea right. top up.
From our Marmite teapot. Marmite teapot. So, more tea. Let me knock it over you
more
just in
vicar.
Case. More tea, vicar. Yes. You did wonder what a vicar and tarts party
you.
Was all about, didn't you?
No,
so,
I didn't.
We have to get somebody to explain. Okay, so what was the question again? I've forgotten now.
On your feet. Oh, the shoes?
Oh, yes, on your feet. So what you've got to do, Karen, nice. Oh, we've got the whole Brighton mob in here today, I think. Tony's is watching as well. Fantastic. Great to see you again. And André Burkhardt,
André,
fantastic
great
from
to
Germany.
See you as well.
Tony, you're from America. Am I right? Is that Tony from America? The
Yes, it's Karen. But not yes. for Tony, I don't think.
No, okay. So the question is, get proper shoes. Proper dance shoes make life so much easier. You know, I have a theory that when you wear a good looking pair of dance shoes, you get more dances. Because people look at you in those shoes, they think, oh, you must be a professional, look at those shoes. And they ask you to dance. So, wear a proper pair of dance shoes, they're comfier, and they move better. See, the reason is dance shoes, Anna,
mm-hmm.
I'll explain.
I'm a bit
dance
distracted
shoes,
by the stones.
I know. Dance shoes have a softer leather. If they're made of leather uppers, they're softer and they're more flexible. So it give you more flexibility. However, unlike a ballroom shoe with a very thin paper wafer thin sole, that doesn't give you any support. Because in Lindy Hop and in swing dance, we tend to bounce a little bit. So you want a bit more support.
A little bit.
You want a bit more support. So a slightly stronger leather sole, or you get the Blair with the rubber sole, it gives you more support.
Yes.
Personally, for social dancing, I do like a leather sole.
Yeah.
You can slide, it gives you support, but it's still flexible. You don't want one of the old-fashioned street shoes with the sole this thick and you can't, you know, creaks to bend. You want something with a bit of flexibility. That, to me, is a perfect shoe. So there we go. So let's see what other people think. That's our tip of the day. Get a decent pair of shoes. Invest in a pair of shoes. In Balboa, a hard sole is good. Absolutely. Especially
yes.
if you want to do slides and hill slides. You need a leather heel if you want to do your hill slides.
Oh, yes.
Now, I did at one point, when I was doing performances, and you wore shoes, you wanted to slide, do hill slides, but you didn't want to slip over during a performance.
Mm.
So, you know, Frankie and his troupe, the Whitest Lindy Hoppers, used to wear trainers.
Mm.
They used to wear the old-fashioned tennis pumps. Trainers. I don't think they were called pumps. Those days. The old-fashioned tennis trainer.
Yeah.
Like Dunlop type things. And they used to wear those, Kent, I think they were called. And they used to wear those because they were more secure dancing super fast. However,
especially with
all
those
what I used
areas.
To do was I used to put a leather sole on the shoe, or if it didn't have one, I'd put one on, and then I'd put a thin rubber layer over the top, and then I would scrape out the little corner where you do your hill slides. So you had leather for hill sliding, but rubber for a bit more support.
But
on
just
the hill.
On the heel.
Just on the heel.
The rubber just on the heel, not on the
No,
finishing.
Actually, I for performing, I tend
you
to, unless I'm doing sort of Balboa, but if I wanted to do slide, then I could slide on the heel, you see.
That was clever.
Yeah. Okay, so Anna, have the first bite.
Oh, right.
This is it. This is the moment you've been waiting for. Right, so you are going to decide. So you're going to have the one.
We're
both going to
decide.
First one got jam and cream,
mm-hmm.
which is that from Devon or
that's
Cornwall?
That's the Cornwall.
That's the Cornwall one. So the Cornwall. So she's tasting it now, folks.
Mm-hmm.
She can't talk, I'll talk for her. She's tasting it. The cream has melted in her mouth. The jam is coming out. Oh, no, actually, lipstick, sorry. The jam is just oozing out. And, of course, you've got the freshly made scone made today by my very own baker, Mademoiselle Fifi here has made the scone, it's very good. Okay, so let me try now.
That's
so
rather good.
I'm going to tell you
nice
keep chatting.
Crumbly scone, sorry. So I can see the top layer has been started. So how's this? Is the scone crumbly enough? Your taste. Is the cream creamy enough?
Remarkably good. Can you hold that for a second?
Right.
So when having a cream tea, one needs to have a...
What's your score?
Mmm. Well, that's very good. That's a 9 out of 10.
Mm.
The thing is, when you've got the cream on top, you can really taste the cream.
Yes, you taste
You do get a lot of taste of cream. So
and
this is a very good...
jam. Food porn.
Food porn.
Right.
Yes, this show has everything.
We don't eat every week on the show, I should note. We talk about food a lot, but we don't normally eat on the show.
This is exceptional. Okay, so now we've got the cream first and the jam. So Anna's taking a bite. Yes, it's all over her mouth. It's all going everywhere. And she's biting down, she's chomping away, and it's looking very exciting. I think this is going to be a very close decision. this is, let's see what the judges say. Second round.
This is a close one.
Mmm. Mmm. See, now...
Now you can really taste the fruit in the strawberry jam, can't you?
So that's interesting. Mm. So I've never done this experiment
before. Me neither,
but this is like the Pepsi Coke challenge.
I know.
So when you've got the cream underneath and the jam on top, you taste the jam first.
Yes, and it's the main taste that you take. So whatever is on top, you taste more of.
Well, that's very, very interesting.
I think we should tell people this is a show about dancing, because if they tune in now, they think it's a cooking show.
Okay, well, as we're on a theme, I think we'll stick with the theme. And this is Food Club by the Ding Dong Daddy-O's. Wonderful Ding Dong Daddy-O's, great
can
guys.
Can I have another bite?
No, you've got to dance
dear.
Now. So
you dance, I'll eat.
I'm going to have a second round. This time I'm going to start with the cream first and the jam on top.
Katrine says, sometimes bring two. Do you mean two scones? No, I think she means two pairs of shoes, because the floor changes as the evening progresses. Quite right, Katrine. Katrine's a professional. And yes, that's the idea. If you don't know where you're going and if you want to dance all night, if you can, you can bring two pairs of shoes. Slightly smoother, slightly stickier.
I will tell you once I finish eating.
Oh, and Bjorn has the same. Sorry, Bjorn, I saw your comment second, but it was actually a similar comment saying one with a leather heel, one with a rubber.
Well, not at the same time, though. You mean one on each
not
foot?
Not one on each. Well, that would be an interesting dance.
Yeah. Now, I've got to tell you a really funny story. Well, I think
I've got a very funny story for you right now, Simon. Glenn's asking, is Simon the Marmite lover?
Ah, well, now.
Very funny. Who likes tea in this house? Who likes Marmite in this house?
I do like Marmite.
No, you do like Marmite.
But you love Marmite. You, yes. You love Marmite.
Oh, I love Marmite.
You know, they say you neither love it nor hate it. I sort of love it, but not as much as you.
Oh, no, not as much.
Okay,
I
now,
was brought up on Marmite.
I do have another quiz question, but I've got to get this in first. I shouldn't really eat cream and talk at the same time.
Well, you shouldn't. So let me have a slurp.
Let me have a little slurp.
Mm.
Okay, interesting story. In 1988, I was going in for a competition.
Interesting, yeah.
Actually, it might have been another one. But anyway, I was going in for a competition at a ballroom. No, it wasn't 1988, it was later.
Well, Simon, and,
may I finish?
Are you telling your story or not?
Yes, I'm telling my story. There's no rush. We're having cream tea. You know, Marmite tea, and I've never had that. Mm. I don't know if that sounds great. I do love Twiglets, though. Now, anyway, so I went into this competition. So I thought, me and my partner thought we'd be very clever.
Mm.
We'd go to the venue a few days before and we'd check out the dance floor because we didn't know the venue. Oh, so,
Anna,
excuse me, are you trying to give everybody, you know, the shakes?
A jump.
Anyway, so we went to the venue and we tried out the floor. We said, okay, it's like this. So we thought, we know what shoes to bring. Of course, on the day, we went back to the venue and the floor was like an ice rink. They had totally polished the floor. Totally made it look shiny, but very, very slippery. Totally different floor. So going ahead of time and checking out the floor doesn't always work. We thought we were so clever until we got there and said, oh, I bought the wrong shoes.
Oops.
Yeah, oops, indeed. It was totally the opposite. Anyway, my question, the last quiz question of the day is we are talking about the quintessential cream tea. Well, do we ever get the answer to the first question?
No, we never did. So
okay,
you,
quickly,
one
give
last
away
chance.
The answer. No, there's no chance.
Oh, okay.
They've lost it now.
So cream tea is consists of tea and scones with cream and jam, clotted cream and jam, I should say, whereas afternoon tea has sandwiches, usually cucumber and cream cheese sandwiches.
Oh, lovely. Mm, I bet cucumber sandwich.
Sandwiches, the cream tea and cakes.
Pastries.
Pastries
little
or little cakes.
Yes, yes.
It's got a three-tier tea.
That's the one. Now, as you didn't get it, I'm going to win the prize. Now, my last question was a very simple one. Quintessential cream tea. We've been talking about that all evening. But what are other quintessential English dishes?
Oh, that's
can somebody tell me? English cuisine.
Mm.
We've got Marmite.
And curry doesn't count.
No. We're not counting curry. So what is quintessentially British food? Let's see what you say.
Yes, Karim quite rightly says no crusts on the cucumber and cream cheese sandwiches.
Oh, absolutely quite right. Oh, quite a refined right. A man after my own heart. With taste. With taste. Okay. Have you had your final pieces? Let's play another song.
One more. How much have you had?
Well, I've had plenty.
Okay.
The rest is for you. I think it's Tea for Two.
Mm-hmm.
Now, we did play a version earlier, but that was by Bob Crosby. This one is by Benny Goodman.
Mm-hmm.
Tea for Two, Benny Goodman. Yeah. I know why you don't want to dance too fast when you have all that cream tea. But Benny Goodman knows how to swing, yeah.
Thank you.
Goodman, Betty Goodman. So we've been taking it nice and easy tonight, not kidding ourselves too much, but let's find out how many steps we've done. We'll look at that later.
But I've got another question. How many scones have you had tonight with us?
Well, yes. Who has been eating scones? Let's find out who has been eating scones. So, crab sandwiches. That's
right.
An interesting one.
So,
like a nice bit of crab.
British. We've got crab sandwiches. I think we have a lot going on
jelly deals.
YouTube.
Oh, I shouldn't give that away, should I?
So we got fish and chips. Yes.
Fish and chips.
Absolutely.
That's a winner.
Roast beef and Yorkshire pudding.
That's a Geordie for you.
I say Yorkshire pudding
proper,
is rather
proper.
Delicious. Cornish pastry, Bakewell tart, fish and chips. Well, that's dinner for me.
Yes.
That'll do me. drop scones. What scones?
Drop is that the scones? No, I don't know. I'm confused. Okay, we're confused by that one.
Are there a type of scone? Emma, tell us. Shepherd's pie.
Shepherd's pie. Now, is that quintessentially English?
Well, I mean, the name is quintessentially English, but we have the equivalent in France, just under a different name.
Yeah, you didn't cook the shepherds, did you?
We didn't. Yorkshire pudding, shepherd's pie.
Jelly deals.
Oh,
you missed out on the
yes,
best
sorry.
Ones.
Well, I don't have my glasses, you know that. Jelly deals. I never tried that. Black pudding. I
never tried that either. Oh, and I do like
pudding.
A nice bit of spotted dick.
Spotted dick.
Oh, yes. Well, that's
I've
good.
I've never tried spotted dick.
Oh, you should have some spotted dick.
I have to say, it's
recommend
not very
it.
Appealing.
Recommend it, wife.
Neither
you
the
should
name
try
or
it.
The look.
Okay. But
how about no one says bread and butter pudding?
Yes. You're
no,
just
think,
not reading there, because
no,
it's right
no,
underneath
no.
you. I think
no,
you need to
look,
borrow my glasses.
Yorkshire pudding. Oh,
Emma
butter
said
pudding.
Bread and butter pudding.
Oh, Emma, I should have known you would have it. Trifle.
Have a closer look.
A mere trifle.
Oh, did somebody say trifle?
Yes,
yeah.
Emma says trifle. Emma
is
right there on the dessert.
Stay in the hole.
She's with me.
Finally, someone said full English breakfast. I was waiting
Sherry
for that
trifle.
One, Andrew.
Oh.
What's that? Mars bar fried in batter. I don't know if that's quintessential. That's Scottish, isn't it? Then it was quintessentially British. Yes, I know, pretty outrageous. Boiled egg and soldiers. Boiled egg and soldiers, come on, that's
well,
a good one.
Well, it is a good one. Again, that's maybe the name is quintessentially British.
So,
tell us, Simon, what's toad in the hole?
Toad in the
I
hole.
I know now, but...
Okay, and that was toad in the hole.
With a sausage in it?
I think so.
That kind of thing? Or is that
I'm a bangs and mash person myself. I like bangs and mash.
Steak and kidney pie? Oh, yeah, all sorts of pie, I think. Stilton and beef and blue cheese or
yeah,
something?
Yeah, Karen says cottage pie. I don't know if
full
cottage
English
pie
breakfast.
Is quintessentially British, though. I don't think Britain, cottage pie. I mean, it probably is an English dish, but I don't see it.
Oh, and we have the one spot with the most Marmite lovers in France.
Oh, yes.
Saying, hello, I know who you are. And I know that when I go back to France, I pack my suitcase with Marmite for those Marmite lovers.
The five lovers of Verdal.
Yeah, there are more, actually, but there are five at the moment.
Actually, I think that'd make a good title for a book. I think I could see The Adventures of the Five Marmite... I can't talk.
Marmite.
The Adventures of the Five Marmite Lovers of Verdal. Say that, I think that's
too many
experiences.
They call it Marmite.
Oh, Marmite.
The Marmite lovers.
Oh, drop scones are like very small pancakes, thicker than a crepe, served with butter and melted. Oh, so butter melts on top. Emma likes her butter, doesn't she? But Emma, I'm with you on that. I'm a bit of a butter person myself, actually. I'm trying to give up a lot of milk, or not very successfully. And I must admit that I can't give up butter. And Karim says sausages in Yorkshire pudding. Oh, that must be toad in the hole.
Yes.
Lovely.
Yes,
so,
thank you.
Gosh, now we've come to that time.
Who said Britain is not a nation of cooks?
Yes. who said that indeed? We've come to that time where it's coming up to the end of the show. So next week's show, I have to tell you, is going to be about Whitey's Lindy Hoppers. So next week's show is about Whitey's Lindy Hoppers.
And you have an interesting swing note that came out.
Oh, actually, well, yes,
yesterday.
I got inspired. No, next week.
Next week. Or is it?
Was it
yesterday?
Week?
No, it was yesterday.
Oh, yeah, it was yesterday. It was the first of a series of swing notes I'm writing about... Whitey's Lindy Hoppers and some of the big names in the group and some of the little names as well.
But you
and
started yesterday with somebody that not everyone talks about when we talk about Whitey's Lindy Hoppers, which is Whitey himself, or
yes.
Herbert White.
Herbert Whitey White.
So I thought that was really interesting, actually. I knew of him, but I discovered a little bit more.
Yeah,
of
and
who he was yesterday.
I mean, he is really instrumental in bringing Whitey's Lindy Hoppers together, and without them, we wouldn't be doing the dance we're doing now.
No,
so
really
very instrumental. He had a vision, and
deserved his reputation. Uh-huh. Now, we're coming to the end of the show, so we need to tell you which we voted for, because we had jam first and then cream, and then we had first and then jam.
That's true.
But before we do, let me tell you about next week's show. Is going to be Weiss's Lindy Hoppers, which we mentioned, SwingdanceUK.com. Mm. Check it out. Sign up for Swing Notes, and you can read about part two. You can read part two. It'll be coming out next Sunday, and it's free. Also, Mind Body Swing. Who's been doing me Mind Body Swing? So I did a Thursday challenge in January, which was every day for 30 days. I did breathing, a thought of the day, a dance warm-up, and then a short dance routine, so it didn't take too long to learn, but some interesting steps, hopefully. And then we did some stretching and exercise at the end. So now I'm doing it once a week. It's free. It's on YouTube.
SwingdanceUK.com.
On Sundays.
YouTube.
Comes out on Sundays.
So Sunday's a great day. They get your swing note, yes. And they get your mind body swing.
Well, we like to keep them busy.
They're set for the week.
So the question is, who did we vote for? Well, folks, it's the end of the show.
Oh,
and
no.
I've got to say, I like pie. I like cake. Last song.
And I like pie, and I like cake, and I like anything you bake, and I like your friendship from the up in Shakespeare. When I see your jelly glow, then I lose my self-control. But of all these things, I like you better.
Show, and the big question on everybody's mind. The big question on everybody's mind.
No.
When the big question on everyone's mind is, which do we prefer? Was it cream first or jam first? And the answer is.
I like a nice cup of tea with me dinner.
there's a lot to be said for a nice girl.